Hello, my friends and fellow modelers. I will show to you how from this I went to this. This is the tropical leaves from a tropical plant from ETA, Diorama Accessories. From Yannis Papadopoulos, and you can find also in the website step-by-step instructions how to do that. It's not quickly, it's not so easy, but if you follow the instructions, you can have a very, very, very realistic appearance that nothing else can do. Nothing else. Still, I need still to paint a matte varnish. But what you have to do? The first thing is to use a very good scissors. I bought this because Tamiya, these two scissors, one for the decals and for the thin paper, and the other for photo etch, are the best in the market. And you have to go little by little, see how easy this, because it's a small, near to the image, it's not necessary to be exactly, because then I will show what you have to do. You can go like this. Okay, you can correct it if you wish. This is really a very good investment. You see how close you can cut, and that's it. It doesn't necessary to be exactly, because as you see later, you have to make then you cut. This is the string, fishing line, the string. It's provided also in the set, in each set for leaves, that is for plants. And you have to cut it in some small parts, like this, irregular. You can put undiluted, perhaps this glue, because it's very transparent and very quickly drying from green stuff. You can put it where you want the plant to be. As I see here, I put it in these two sides, because my Japanese soldiers are going to shoot diagonally like this, and leave it to dry. Then choose a dark green color. I choose this from Green Stuff because it is nice, and you must paint the strings. You see, you must paint one by one, but it's easily. Afterwards, you must. I have another very good tool from Tamiya. This is plier, bending pliers, also for photo etch, but I found it very, very useful to bend the leaves like this. Of course, you can make it by something else, but it's very handy to do that. For me, it was very easy. Make the bending like this, and you have this one. Okay, so why I have you this palette here? Because to show to you how easily is to paint the remaining of white. You see here, from the cut, you have a remaining white edge. So, when you glue it there, you will need the brush, not so big brush, maybe a flat brush, and you going to paint like this. Okay, it's very easy, very easy. Using this part of the brush. Ready. But I suggest you to do that when you glue it. For the gluing, you must put a little glue here inside. As you see, as you can see, it's also printed in both sides because it's you save time to paint also in the inside the green. And you have to put the liquid glue, PVA glue here, but undiluted. Then put it in the string that is. You have to see how this will go, where to put it, and that's it. Then you have to be careful that I didn't know from the start. When you put the string, don't put it all the way. Put it like somewhere here, just to hold the leaf. Just to hold the leaf, because otherwise you will have you cannot bend the leaves. Otherwise. And nice weathering. You see how realistic this is. So, bend it, glue it to the string that you already glue it in the base where you want to put the plant. Then you can play like that. Okay, put inside. Don't glue the string more than this part, so you can bend the other part. I didn't do it and I have some problems that I corrected. And what will be the result? The result will be a very realistic tropical plant in 135 scale. You have also, you can find also in 72 and 148 some of this. You can go to the site of ETA. And it fits very well to the part of model scene grass mat that I had it in my stock for some years, and I didn't want to spend it, but was the time now. I put this, I cut this according to the dimensions. I use scissors, but a scissors that is for hard work, not for paper or something, because it's a little tough to cut it. I glued it with this very quickly and very reliable with green stuff PVA glue, and I have already the base. I didn't mask this because I will repaint it black. So I think that is getting rather well the base. The only thing that I need now is the matte varnish, some weathering in the base, and to put the figure. But it's going, as you can see here, this is underneath. It's painted already. But you have to paint the edges from the cutting point. And I'm very happy with this. I played a little different. I had a nostalgia for the plastic figure from Tamiya, and this soldier, the Japanese soldiers, is getting, I think it's more than 30 years, more than 30 years, 40 years, 75, and I also pass a second primer. I use this time, this one. It's very thin, probably it's very good for small figures. It's very thin. This is the second one. Of course, the plastic underneath was dark green, olive green, so it needs a lot of layers, but it's drying flat, very, very flat. So I think that here the adhesion of the paint will be excellent. You see here, if I show some, for instance, some defects, I correct it. But I like this very much. I go for the painting. Probably I will use green stuff paints, but perhaps I go for my more precise and more convenient for me with Vallejo. I haven't decided yet. I will see and I will decide later. But I think that this is for plastic figure. The base will be a different theme. See you soon.